Hello guys, in the last class we discussed how R2 by S is resolved in terms of R2 plus R2 into bracket 1 minus S by S, where R2 represents the copper loss, where the remaining R2 into bracket 1 minus S by S represents the equivalent electrical mechanical load, okay, of the motor. So let's move, and again this particular part, the second part, two parts are there, no? This is the first part and this is the second part, and the second part is also called as what? Load, RL, okay, load resistance. Can replace this by RL, but you should know what RL mean. RL is equal to R2 into bracket 1 minus S by S, okay. So here you can see that rotor equivalent circuit as shown as, means they have written the rotor circuit, okay, it is not stator, this is only rotor when referred to the primary and all. So they are writing the rotor circuit in terms of three. So let us start with the first one. This is the rotor equivalent circuit part A, and hope you know this, how this has come. This is already we discussed in the book, yes or not? You can see here, yes or not? E2R, R2, SX2. So you know how this rotor circuit has come, okay. So the first one has got no any problem in understanding. The second one, E2, X2 is in series with R2 by S. How this thing came? This thing is written in terms of this. Both are same, okay. Both, all three are same, in fact, okay. Now let us see how it has come here. You can see, already we discussed this thing, the rotor circuit which we have discussed earlier, can be written in terms of this, yes or not? I2R, because I2R is equal to S times of E2 divided by S. Square root of R2 square plus SX2 whole square. The same thing can be written as like this. So what I've done here, I've taken S square common. So S square common is S will come out, SS gets cancelled. So this is what which we discussed earlier. So finally what happens in that rotor circuit, I2R is there, E2 is there, and R2 by S is there as well as X2 is there. This is what we need to account for. Okay. So three things, I2R, E2, R2 by S as well as X2. Okay. Four things, 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is what we have accounted here. You can see, E2 is there, I2R is there, X2 is there, as well as R2 by S is there. So we have accounted the rotor circuit in terms of another circuit or same circuit in different manner. Okay, both are electrically equivalent. Okay, there is no any problem. Now coming to the third one, rotor equivalent circuit. Yes, here I should take help of this. Anyhow, we know that X2 is in series with R2 by S, so we shall not touch this X2. But we know that R2S, whatever it is here, it can be resolved in terms of like this, which I discussed. So it can be resolved in like this, R2 plus R2 divided by 1 minus S by S. So this is what I need to add in the existing circuit. Okay. So X2 is there, X2 is already there, which is present. R2 by S is there. No, this is what we have resolved in two parts, R2 plus R2 into bracket 1 minus S by S. The same thing can be written in terms of what? RL. Okay. So RL is equal to R2 into bracket 1 minus S by S. So this is what we have with the rotor equivalent circuit in three different manners, okay, but they are all electrically equivalent. Now let's start with equivalent circuit referred to stator. So for that, what we do is we shall transfer all the rotor parameters to the stator parameter, because we are referring from the stator, no? So that's why the reason we are transferring all the components or all the terms which have come in the rotor circuit into the primary circuit. I mean, transferring all this E2R, R2, SX2, I2R, everything in terms of into the stator part. So I am referring from here stator. So I am transferring whole components to the stator part. Okay, from rotor to stator. And again, we know that this is a transformer ratio. K is equal to E2 by E1. And again, how this has come? E2 dash equal to E2 by K. I have made some notes here, so we can refer here. So equivalent circuit refer to the stator. We shall start from here. It will be better to understand. So like I said, I am going to transfer all the parameters to the stator side from the rotor side. So now what I am going to do is, I am going to shift E2. Since I am concerned with E2 now, let us see the remaining parts like R2, I2, X2, everything. We shall see later. First we shall go with the EMF E2. So obviously we know that in the rotor part we have EMF E2. So I am going to transfer from rotor to the stator. So if I transfer, what it becomes? It becomes E2 dash, which you all know. So it is the same like that of your like your transformer, which we have referred in the primary while discussing that. Okay. So E2 dash. And we know that in primary what flows there? I1 flows. Okay. So that's what happens. Therefore, I can write in terms of like this. This is a power equation. P1 is equal to P2, because we know that whatever power input is there, it will be equal to the power output. Yes or not? Means including losses and all. I should mention that also. So E2 dash I1 is equal to what? E2 into I2. So E2 and I2 are specifically with respect to the rotor, and E2 dash is what? It is the terminology which changed after transferring from rotor to stator, and I1 is the parameter which is already flowing in the stator part. So power in primary becomes, that in stator becomes, E2 dash equal into I1 equals power present in the rotor, that is E2 into I2. Okay, power in the stator is equal to power in the rotor. So I'm going to transfer this I2 over here. So E2 dash into bracket, or just simply write it as cross multiplier, I1 by I2 equal to E2. And we know that I1 by I2 is equal to K. Yes or not? We have the relation. So E2 dash into K. So I'm going to replace this I1 by I2 by K. I'm going to write it as E2 dash K equal to E2. So E2 dash equal to E2 by K. So this is how E2 dash is what has come into picture. E2 dash equal to E2 by K. This is what they have written directly. They are written here. E2 dash equal to E2 by K. Okay. Now let us not bother about that. Now let us do similar thing with respect to R2 dash. R2. So after shifting R2 to the stator, it becomes what? R2 dash. Right. And now same thing I'm going to write here also. We equalized power in the stator is equal to power in the rotor. The same thing I'm going to equalize here also. Power in the stator is equal to power in the rotor. And again, one more way of representing power is what? In terms of I square into R. And we know that current flowing in the stator is I1. So I1 square into R2 dash, because R2 dash is the terminology which is referred to the stator after transferring from rotor to stator. So I1 dash square into R2 dash is equal to what? Power in the rotor. So I2, we know that current flowing in rotor part is I2. Yes, I2 square into R2, right? Now similarly, again I'm going to transfer this side in this manner. I2 by I1 whole square it becomes into R2. We know that I1 by I2 equal to K, which I already told. I1 by I2 equal to K, then I2 by I1 will be equal to 1 by K. Yes or not? I2 by I1 equal to 1 by K. So 1 by K actually it is square, right? So 1 by K whole square. So 1 square is 1. Again 1 by K square. R2 dash equal to 1 by K square times of R2. Or else you can write it in fashion of, in terms of like this. Same itself. R2 dash equal to R2 by K square. So if I got the equivalent resistance, that is R2 dash, equivalent resistance, it is the rotor resistance R2 dash in terms of R2 by K square. This is what we got here. R2 dash equal to R2 by K. So the similar thing we can do with the reactance also. Can do similar thing with respect to the reactance also, because reactance is acts like same as that of resistance. It has got same formula. If I do the same thing, I'll be getting what? X2 dash equal to X2 by K square. No need to again mention once again. Once you know this, it is same, because resistance and reactance are having what? Same SI unit. So formulas will be same. Just replace R by X. Okay. The rest will be remain same. This is voltage. Okay. Then this is resistance. And similarly, load resistance, that is RL is there, right? RL is there, true or not? RL was there here. Where it was? Here it was. Now I have transferred R2, I have transferred X2, I have transferred E2. Now I am going to what? Transfer RL. Okay, here they haven't mentioned I2 and all. Let us see that later part. Okay. Now we are going to transfer RL. Means precisely R2 into bracket 1 minus S by S. So it will be clumsy. So I am going to transfer RL. Okay, RL into primary means, in the stator means, it becomes RL dash. So after transferring RL, it becomes RL dash. So again, we know that it has got same SI unit of that of rotor resistance R2 as well as X2. So the formula will be also in the same manner. Just replace R2 by RL and the rest will be same. So RL dash equal to RL by K square. And again, you can see that the other part is also transferred here. Okay, if I can restrict the formula, I can do restriction till here. If I going to transfer all this, that is R2 into bracket 1 minus S by S, means I can do that thing also. That's what it is written here. RL is nothing but what? R2 into bracket 1 minus S by S. And again, we know that after replacing RL by R2 into bracket 1 minus S by S, we get what? R2 by K square. And again, we know that R2 by K square is what? R2 dash. So I'm going to replace R2 by K square is equal to R2 dash. So collectively the formula will become what? RL dash equal to R2 dash into bracket 1 minus S by S. Okay, so you should know what R2 dash exactly is. R2 dash is R2 by K square, which you have wrote earlier. Now coming to the I2 part, that is current part. Like I said, I2 is not shown here. Should have shown here. I2 is the current which is flowing in the rotor part. The same thing is done here. And again, after shifting I2R, means usually we consider rotor current in terms of running. So I2R have represented here. After shifting I2R to the stator, what becomes? It becomes I2R dash. And similarly, I am going to write the power formula. P1 is equal to P2, means power in the stator is equal to power in the rotor. So E1 I2R dash, that is the stator part, is equal to what? E2 into I2R, because E2 is specifically with respect to what? Rotor, and I2R is specifically with respect to rotor, and E1 is specifically with respect to stator, but I2R dash is transferred term, so it does belong to the primary because we are transferred. So E1 into I2R dash equal to E2 into I2R. Anyhow, I need in terms of I2R, right? So I'm going to write in terms of this. I2R dash, equal to what? E2 by E1. So E1 I'm going to transfer here. It becomes what? E2 by E1 into I2R. So you can see that E2 by E1 is nothing but what? K. It's a transformer ratio which you already know. So I2R dash equal to K times of I2. So this is what we have formula with respect to the current. I2R is rotor current. Now I'm going to consolidate all the things in terms of in a single circuit. This you already know, this is the stator part, it's the excitation part, R1, X1, I1, Z1 is the impedance of the stator, I0 is the magnetizing current, which includes IC as well as IM, I0, okay, it's also called as no load current, okay, precisely IC is the core loss current, IM is the magnetizing current, and again we are going to transfer R2 as R2 dash, and X2 has become as X2 dash, and again collectively R2 dash and X2 dash is called as what? Z2 dash. And again I2R dash, because I2R is going to transfer to the primary, so it becomes what? I2R dash. And anyhow, we know that we have transferred RL into the stator part, becomes RL dash. Again, RL dash we already learnt here. R2 dash into bracket 1 minus S by S, which you have proved here. So no, R2 dash into bracket 1 minus S by S. So all the parameters now I have transferred to the primary, as we are looking at the from the stator part. Okay. Now what I will do is, now I will try to make this equivalent circuit much more simpler. How that can be done? I'm going to transfer this excitation circuit to the left of R1, X1. Okay. Anyhow, by doing so, we are making errors, but that's what I'm saying. I'm trying to make it simpler in terms of approximate. You can call it as what? Approximate equivalent circuit. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to transfer this R0, X0, whatever parallel parameters are there, towards the left side of this part. Okay. So this is how I am going to do. So after transferring, you can see I1, I0, IC, IM, same thing it remains here. But what happens, whatever R1, X1 was before this, now it has come after this, okay, here. And rest of things are same, X2 dash, R2 dash, R2 dash into bracket 1 minus S by S, again similarly I2R dash. Okay, like I said, we are making mistake, we are making some errors, which is not exactly equivalent circuit to the earlier one. That's why it is called as what? Approximate equivalent circuit. Okay. So by doing so, this is what we have. Again, we can sum up this R1 plus R2 dash as here you can see. R1 plus R2 dash, I can call it as R1E. X1 plus X2 dash, I can call it as X1E. Okay. And again, we know that I2 dash, the similar thing they have written here. After summing up R1 R2 dash, it has become R1E. And summing up X1 and X2 dash, it has become what? X1 in the rest is same. Okay, much more simpler circuit. And the remaining circuit, you know, I1 dash equal to I0 plus I2R dash. Yes or not? It's the can apply KCL over here for this node. I1 is equal to I0 plus I2R dash. Similarly, I0 is equal to IC plus IM. IC and IM, they have not shown. Make sure you show here IC as well as IM. IC will supply core loss as well as IM will supply what? Utilized for the magnetizing the circuit. Okay. So, this is the equivalent circuit as shown in the figure. So this is what the approximate equivalent circuit. Okay.